going to see the circuit between the brain cortex and or cerebral cortex and the cerebellar cortex. So this is also called the cerebellar circuit. So we will begin in the cortex. Let's say the patient is facing to the camera. So this is the right side and the left side. Here is the first neuron on the motor cortex or Brodmann areas 4 and 6. This neuron descends all the way down to the pons. Here in the pontine nuclei is the first synapse. Next, this promotes the second order neuron. This is the second order neuron that decussates. So goes now to the contralateral side and enters to the cerebellum. Let me put the cerebellum. Here's the cerebellum. So because it is entering, this is entering through the from pontine nuclei to the cerebellum is the medial cerebellar pedunculum. And these are mosifibers that are entering to. Mosifibers go to the granular and the Golgi cells. Here I care about the granular cells because here's a granular cell. The granular cell then stimulates the Purkinje cells. So from granular cell to the Purkinje cell. Granular mosifibers release the excitatory neuron. Actually, all the neurons that we're going to see here are excitatory neurons except Purkinje cells. So, mosifibers release the excitatory neurotransmitter to the granular cells. Actually, they release glutamate. Then, granular cells release glutamate to the Purkinje cells. And Purkinje cells release a GABA, or an inhibitory neurotransmitter. These Purkinje cells are on the dentate nuclei. And now, they go out through the... The only output is through the superior cerebellar peduncles. And these axons are the axons of the Purkinje cells. Now, they are going to do synapse on the red nuclei. Red nuclei of the midbrain. So let me put it more here. Red nuclei. But before they do synapse, this superior cerebellar peduncle decussate. So the synapse is on the red nucleus, but of the contralateral side. And this tract is called, if it's going from the dentate nucleus to the red nuclei and then to the thalamus, is called the dentatorubrotalamic tract or dentatorubrotalamic tract. And now these neurons can do synapse on the red nucleus or can go directly. So one synapse and go to the thalamic or just directly. Just pass through the red nucleus without doing synapse and go to the thalamic nucleus. This is the ventrolateral nuclei of the nucleus of the thalamus. And from here they project again to the primary motor cortex as they were originally. So there is a double decussation on this pathway. This pathway is involved in planning functions of the movements, planning sequencing of vocal cords, of the movements of the fingers, etc. But begins, the planning function begins on the right motor cortex and ends up on the right motor cortex when this neuron then is the upper motor neuron and then go to the lower motor neuron. So we end up activating our upper motor neuron on the same side. So the cerebellar pathway cross, they do a double crossing, so they end up on the same side. So this circuit between this cerebral and cerebellar cortex begins with the primary cortex. This go to the ipsilateral pontine nuclei through the synapse, then through the mossy fibers in the middle cerebellar peduncle. They decussate the synapse on the granular cells, project to the Purkinje cells of the dentate nucleus, Purkinje cells and the dentate nucleus, and then these axons of the Purkinje cell through the superior cerebellar peduncle. Decussate, they go to the red nucleus, doing synapse or not, ascend to the ventralateral nucleus of the thalamus, and they go back to the upper motor neuron of the ipsilateral cerebral cortex.